I'm Krystl Fabella, and I am the founder of Filipina on the Rise, which is the leading podcast on Filipino women and culture, and a media platform seeking to elevate powerhouse Pinays and promote Filipina excellence. I was born in the Philippines, in Manila. I moved to the United States at 7. Growing up in a predominantly white and Filipino neighborhood, I saw a lot of Filipinos around me going into the healthcare route. However, I always felt like I didn't fit in that route. I admit that the irony of Filipino on the Rise is that growing up, I didn't really feel connected with Filipino pride or culture. So fast forward to college, I left the pre-med route and I went to business and all these other things. I tried to join some Filipino groups, but again, I just didn't feel like I clicked. And I graduated college and went to San Francisco Tech. And again, I saw a lack of diversity and I just, again, didn't really see much Filipinos in our space. I do remember one day though, working in tech, that I was on the way back home and I just felt really in a defeated season. I was in an Uber and I was searching up on YouTube stories of successful Filipino women. And then I went on podcasts as I listened to podcasts a lot and I typed in Filipino women and I found nothing. It hit me that moment that this really matters. I felt the pain of invisibility like I'd never seen before. I realized this lack of representation that I pushed away my whole life, that I said didn't matter, it freaking mattered. I promised to myself at that point that I would do whatever it took to find these stories. I live by the mantra of find a hole in the world in the shape of you and fill it. I started this podcast with my iPhone in my walk-in closet. It blew my mind, all the amazing Pinays that were out there, that were entrepreneurs, that were industry disruptors. And since then, I've just been really blessed to have them come on the show. We have over 30,000 listeners now, almost close to 100,000 downloads. We have, you know, our own global membership community. We have multi-series events. We just had a New York City event where there's close to 70 attendees. And I also launched a fashion line where we got to dress Ruby Ibarra at the Grammys. But I have this radical belief that Filipino women stepping into leadership, into decision-making roles, into just creating badass things is what's gonna heal and bring newness into our world. So a big challenge, I think, is that even though you don't see the growth, you don't take the easy way out, you don't see the algorithmic explosion, it still matters to do this work. The first year, I didn't see a lot of growth. The second year is when the pandemic hit, and that's when a lot of Filipino women started tapping more into their identity and culture and looking for these stories. Be okay with planting seeds. Be okay with slow growth, because slow and steady wins the race, and you'd rather put in things that are magnetizing the kind of audience and community that you want versus just everybody. Some of the life lessons that I've learned in this journey is doing and building things without the external validation. And that's really rooted in me being such a people pleaser and performer growing up. I think that I have to consistently tune back in and say, like, why is this work important? And make it not about me and making it about the community on the other side. Be okay if you have a passion or something you want to lean into. Be okay with knowing you're probably gonna fail a few times before you get it right. It's that process of like learning how not to do things that will get you closer to the end product. Ignorance is bliss, and just learn that the right resources will come, and it's all about timing. And second, a lot of things I have to do and make decisions really intuitively. We're taught to lean on other structures, especially when you're creating something that hasn't been created before, especially with trailblazing. You have to consistently listen to like your intuition. So you need to really find quiet time, day to day, of listening to your soul's voice and your body and your own desires. We're currently in a time that really glamorizes the ability to produce nonstop, the ability to just keep going and keep expressing our thoughts nonstop. We've been conditioned through social media, the digital age, the information age, to constantly be consuming. I think we can start healing and benefiting so much more when we take the power off of our digital world and we start creating community again in real life. We start learning each other's stories and connecting with each other again in real life, however that looks. Structure your week with meeting other people in real life through community care, through learning and rebuilding what real relationships and real impact looks like, which is in the real world.